Where am I going with this? In business, there's something called need finding. It is the process that precedes any product or service a business chooses to manufacture or render. Business, then, fundamentally is a set of strategic and cost-effective solutions to these needs that were found slash discovered. Need finding as a theoretical construct and a research method was developed by Robert McKim at Stanford University in the 1970s. The essence of it is captured by the famous Henry Ford quote, "If I'd ask people what they wanted, they'd have said faster horses." In case you still didn't catch it, the point there is every client or customer has a want or a need. Need finding is about disregarding the wants of your prospective clientele and strictly focusing on catering to their needs. Being aware of need finding isn't very helpful if you are unaware of the type of needs your prospective clientele might have and display. These type of needs range anywhere from implicit needs, implied, though not directly expressed, explicit needs, directly expressed, latent needs, not presently evident. The list of needs obviously continues, depending on your perspective and approach. What are the needs of your clients or prospective clients at any given point in time? Can you cater to these needs? The depth and urgency of their need, also their ability to pay, dictates the quality of your service, regardless of how good your taste is. How to grow your business. This section is for the entrepreneur who is starting off their business and reaches a point where they realize that they are actually struggling to grow the business. The question then is, how do you grow your business? The answer I'll provide in this regard is merely my opinion and a segment in an entire spectrum of possible solutions. Meaning my answer isn't applicable or practical to all. Meaning you've been warned. To grow your business conceptually and practically speaking should be easy. I'm not saying this because it is my opinion. I'm saying this because the mechanics of business has changed over the last two decades. It's in your best interest to constantly adapt and be mindful of this constant change. To grow your business, you can try to print and distribute little pamphlets and posters, etc. You can try newspaper advertisements, etc. I'm not suggesting these methods don't work. I've personally tried them and they didn't work as expected. I had to reflect on why they weren't as effective as I expected. And it's from this angle I'll be touching on how to grow a business. Let's assume you're a math tutor or you are busy selling cupcakes. The best way to grow your little tutoring business will be to give 2 to 3 free classes to a bunch of potential clients. When you are selling cupcakes, the best way to grow your business is to start out by giving people a bunch of free cupcakes. This sounds crazy and way too easy, but when you study things like nudge theory, when you're aware of priming, reciprocity, and anchoring, which are extensions of behavioral economics, crowd manipulation techniques, then you'll come to appreciate why I'm professing this to be a golden strategy. Let's take anchoring as an example. If you are really as good as you think you are at math, give free classes. And if your style of tutoring really is as good as you reckon it is, then it makes sense that your newfound set of students wouldn't mind paying you for more sessions. The same apply to our cupcake entrepreneur. If they really are as good as you think they are, then surely your prospective clientele won't mind purchasing from you now on, taking into account the fact that they've tasted your product, meaning they can now compare it to everything else in the marketplace. Found in what I'm actually trying to say is the application of the concept of anchoring.